Do you get much repair work? I mean, do you...
Yeah.
Do you...
I'm the person that people come to when they have a tattoo they want covered up, and 10 tattoo studios over the last 15 years have said, no, nothing can be done with it.
Oh my God, you're the last resort.
Yeah. And oftentimes, there is maybe one, maybe two images that will fit adequately over that. So the client may only have two words of input. And then I have to figure out what the hell I'm going to do with this. I have my canvas, but I have that restriction. The amount of black, whether or not it was applied professionally or by an amateur, is going to depict what I can do with that. That has to be worked into it. Frequently what we do is take the darkest area, cover it with a secondary element, and take a fresh piece of skin and provide a new primary element, so the viewer sees that first, the head of the dragon, and then the covered tattoo then becomes part of the secondary elements, broken up by scales, a foot, some clouds, and is almost just melted into the background.
What's the most common reason for a do-over or a fix-up or whatever you call it?
It's too small, it doesn't fit. You get a huge guy who's got an eagle that looks like a postage stamp. And I've done this. It looks like you've zoomed in. He wants an eagle. Give him an eagle that fits his arm.
Well, we've been at this. I mean, people have been getting tattoos long enough now that we've got folks, lots of folks, I suppose, who are in senior homes and the skin has started to...
Yes.
Have you ever had to do any touch-up on that sort of... Let's hope not.
There was... he's still alive, actually. He's Canadian. His name is Carol Nightingale. Smokey Nightingale. He tattooed in Washington, D.C. From the late 50s to the late 70s. Legend in this business. I had a large, retired Marine come in who had a Semper Fi Eagle Globe, but the Semper Fi was not in the banner. It was 35, 40 years old, and it was faded, and was a Carol Nightingale piece.
He got it tattooed. That's like touching up a Rembrandt.
Yes. He wanted the Semper Fi added. I said, yeah, sure, I will do it. I mixed pigment to match the faded pigment.
Like an art forger.
Exactly. And restored his tattoo by adding that Semper Fi. And honored to do it, honored to touch a classic piece done by a master that 35, 40 years later still looked good. It was a little faded and a little blurred, but that's experience, that's life experience being reflected in the tattoo. It ages, it becomes more a part of the person wearing it, and I was honored to do that.
Did you ever have anybody, a customer, client, I'm not sure what you call it, who's halfway through a piece of work,
right,
who changes their mind?
No, never.
I mean, you wouldn't think so, but, I mean, there's no going back.
The consultation process weeds all of that out. And we go into this with commitment. As a phrase in tattooing and in many other businesses, you know, there is no try. You do or you don't. There's no trouble.
Did you ever... Well, here's the question.
Yeah.
How do you train yourself and others to resist the temptation to say, oh, shit?
Oh, I say it all the time. I'm sorry.
Just yeah, every once in a while, you just throw it out there and just keep them on their toes.
And the general reaction is?
What? Nothing. I was just thinking of something I left on at home, you know.
That may be the meanest thing I have ever heard.
Oh, no, I can do much meaner, but that's about all I
have. Oh, no, the mean thing is when you're working on somebody's back and you say, you did want three testicles on this penis, and they go, what?
Oh, that, you know, see, that leads to a question I'm not even going to ask. I'm not even going to go down that. So, a little background about Paul Rowe and British Ink and how you wound up here?
Well, obviously, I'm British. I've been in the United States for 18 years now. Came over on vacation, met my beautiful wife, flew back 6 months later, grabbed another suitcase, and this is home. Live Washington, D.C. Been tattooing in Washington for 11 years. Graphic design background. Worked in a bunch of restaurants in New York City. I'm a member of the Sommelier Society of America.
And you love your work?
I love my work. It's so interesting. It's different every single day. I do a Japanese piece in the morning and a Celtic piece in the afternoon, and then tomorrow is a traditional, old school, Western traditional sailing ship, followed by some Polynesian black work. And every day I wake up knowing that today's going to be new, today's going to be different, and one day I might get to tattoo feds.
An art with no tolerance for mistake.
No, none at all.
You don't feel the pressure from that?
Yeah, of course. Every time you tattoo, you have to have that in the back of your head.
You can't have a bad day where you slip up.
If you have a bad day, you reschedule your appointments.
You sort of feel like it's today.
My reputation walks out the door with every single piece. I can't afford to go in there with the flu and not perform to the best of my ability.
See, when I screw up on a web page and somebody says, "Oh my God, you've got a typo," I go in and fix it, and I go back and I said, "You must be mistaken."
Exactly.
I mean, it's so impermanent. I mean, what I do is the antithesis of what you do. Yours is indelible.
There is no eraser.
We,